Hey guys, it's Jeff Lafferty, and back for another. Sorry. Actually, I taped my camera, my tripod, to my table so I don't get fall over, get kicked. Well, that's what the noise is. But anyway, it's what is it? Episode number 11. That's awesome. I'm past 10. On to 11. On to 1 million, probably. I don't know. I see guys with like 300-400 videos on YouTube, and I used to always be like, man, that's like crazy. But what's crazy is like I'll actually kind of hit that, something like that, if I just keep going with this every day. So what's going on? I actually got color sprayed on Wolverine, finally. And doesn't look that good. A lot of times when I spray color, I actually think I kind of mess things up. A lot of times I think it's like the worst the piece will look is when I do the blacks and do the color. And I don't know if you can see it all. Let me move it around. You can kind of see the figures a lot better now. From my sketch, it was kind of hard, but you know, Mystique, Magneto, Viper, Cap, Silver Samurai, which this one, Silver Samurai, when I heard that I had to put Silver Samurai in this one, I was kind of like, eh, I'm not that into it. I actually love the way this figure looks in here, though. And we got the Hulk, and we got Wolverine fighting, Sabretooth up there. And, of course, we got the iconic shot of Wolverine. And I don't know, I think it's a good start right now. I'm just so scattered this morning, though, because I did an interview, actually, with a guy. What's this guy's name? His name is Jay, and he's from moonlightcreations.blogspot, and he does a magazine called Dark Muse Magazine. So he interviewed me this morning for for the magazine. And through talking to him, I guess he's an artist. I haven't really got a chance to look his stuff over. And he says he's on YouTube too, so later I'm going to find it. And when I do, I'll stick his links in the show notes. But it was very cool. Very cool interview, and it's fun. It's, you know, it's like something I miss about doing the podcast. It's just fun to talk to other artists, you know. Sometimes I feel like that's what I'm missing in this thing, is talking to other artists, but I actually can't. I don't know. That would be really hard to try to set up, like talking to someone on Skype and then also filming at the same time. And getting all the audio together, and I barely have enough time to just turn the camera on. Shoot, render it, stick it on YouTube, and it's like, man, it's time to freaking get up and shoot the next one. I stayed up like super late last night. This I all did kind of during the day, but this night I actually did this piece, which took a fair amount of kind of research and stuff. Just a drawing rough for a, let me see. Let me move my camera so I can see what's on the screen. There we go. Make sure you guys can see it. It's a rough for a book cover. And haven't heard back if they're like it or not. I'm not quite sure if this will be a job that actually happens or not. So, but I like the piece. I think it's very cool. And it's also like, you know, stretching my muscles in a different area. And I don't know. I might even stick this on eBay. Because I think it turned out really nice. If they don't end up taking the cover anyway. I guess I'm a little bit, I don't know if it's going to happen. I just, for some reason, I kind of got the vibe that I shouldn't probably say that stuff on the video, but I seriously got there looking at my videos, but I just got the vibe that they just were kind of like, let's try this out, and let's try this out, and let's try this out, you know, kind of thing. So anyway, I think they just wanted to try out Jeff Lafferty. So anyway, like I said, I was up late last night doing that. Move all my stuff over. Get my picture a little bit more like that. Now I have all these masks, and I also, the whole reference and everything for this piece is just scattered everywhere on my table. Jerk my cord, I hope I didn't unplug the camera. I didn't even do a test run to make sure the audio was working. So hopefully everything's gonna work on this one, we're just going for it. I don't really remember what I was, I got cut short on last week's video too, and I don't really remember even. Let's just move that up a little. Remember I was talking about marketing and all that kind of stuff, but I don't know that I'm in focus anymore now. Anyway, let's just get on with it. So I guess I'm going to start with the central figure, just because I've got some brown on my airbrush still, so I don't want to change into like a green or a color like that. Even though I'm going to kind of work over top of myself, and it's not the ideal situation. For that, I mean I'm going to have my hand on top of stuff that I did. I always kind of just start dropping in the lights. What's nice about this and this kind of style, I think, is it's just like with each pass, you can fix stuff and you can make it better. Because some of these portraits, I don't think look quite like the people, especially Mystique here. Her face doesn't look quite like the chick from Hunger Games, but it's like close enough. I can see where I'm wrong, that I can fix it when I paint it. I think I'm going to be on the money when I get done, but like right now, it's just not quite there. But yeah, I just feel like almost talked out after talking to Jay for an hour or whatever we talked. I just feel like, oh, I'm tired of talking. I don't want to talk to anybody now. But got to. I got to get this video done. I got to stick with it. Gotta stick with it. I didn't, and I'm kind of like mad at myself a little bit because I didn't get this piece further along. I got kind of distracted yesterday by shipping. A lot of the stuff I sold on eBay is coming off eBay now, so it's like I gotta make sure all that's right. I gotta ship my prints to the Patreon people. And so, you know, I just kind of, I didn't really work quite as long as I usually do in here yesterday, and then last night I was kind of debating whether I should even do that rough for the lady with the mermaid book, but then I thought, well, you know, what's the difference, you know, it's like, and it also, I liked the idea, it wasn't like something I just wouldn't want to paint. I thought, that's kind of cool, that's in a genre, or, you know, like fantasy art, I like fantasy art. And I've kind of wondered sometimes, like, what I could do with my style if I did a little more of it. I think I've started some stuff and then didn't get it done around here, and I don't know. This is like what's going on is I got this, there's just so much junk on my little piece of paper here that I sharpen my pencils on and I kind of touch it with the paint and stuff when I paint here, you know what I mean? I kind of get a good tip so I can do tight lines, especially with the Prismacolors, they need a lot of sharpening, at least the way I do them. But anyway, what's kind of happening here is you see, like, I don't know if you can see that pencil. It's actually getting some black off this, so I need to get rid of this and get a new one. Let me throw this away. Copy paper is buried underneath a bunch of books, so it kind of got bent when I took it out. And also, that'll be fine though. I actually like to, you know, have some kind of a little bit rougher paper, I used to have this gray copy paper that was kind of, it's actually really nice to draw on, but it's not, you know, it's kind of real flimsy, so I don't do draw it very often, but I'll flip that over. I'm having all kinds of troubles. So I don't want the rip catching up on my picture. But I like that a little better, because then it's got a little tooth and it sharpens my pencil up a little quicker. Let's see, I already dropped a pencil. Let's see. I'm glad everybody seems to like the videos. I appreciate that. I kind of really worried, especially after I got started, that I really wouldn't be able to stick with them. Because of, you know, it just, I don't know, you're sitting around talking to yourself, and it's like, how much do you got to say sometimes? And I don't know, it always seems like I got something to talk about. It seems like once, I always flip the camera, and I think, I got nothing to talk about. And then I sit here for a while, and the next thing I know, it filled up like an hour's worth of me just talking, you know. It's almost like a therapy session for me. And people seem to be digging it, which is really cool. That's kind of what I hoped would happen. Sharp my pencil up here. Gotta get all these sharp because it's like I just started this piece, so I kind of had to go through and find some colored pencils, and you know, they're all kind of semi-dull, and it's just like some stuff you gotta kind of do before you get going full speed onto a piece, you know. I think Tanya and them are gonna come back pretty soon too, but I think I might just keep trying to record. And I've done podcasts, but then Tristan was younger, and in here while they were out in the living room, and they never seemed to mind. Tristan's so good. He's getting it. Like, you know, I always used to have to go to work out the door in the morning, and he'd kind of get up. He'd always seem to make it up right as I was leaving, which was cool because that would make me late. But he's just, he was so good about, you know, not giving a big fit or anything when I had to leave. When I had to leave, I would, you know, Tanya usually wouldn't get up, so maybe like, go jump back in bed with your mama and snuggle up till she wakes up, you know. And he'd do it. And now it's like, you know, because I always say I have to go to work, and he kind of gets it. It's like, when I have to go to work, I have to go to work. And like, even now, like, you know, I thought I might have kind of trouble just getting in my studio, and he's cool. I mean, he's just like this morning, like I had to come in here, and they were getting ready to go to the park anyway, but I was just like, yeah, Dad's gotta work. And he's like, okay, Dad, you know, go to work. It was really cool. I remember I have two brothers. I have two younger brothers, but one of them's 3 years younger than me. And one of them's 15 years younger than me. He's my half-brother. His name's Tim. And when he was a little kid, because like when he was little, you know, he was born like when I was about 15, so I got to see him grow up, you know. We've always been like super close. He was really, it's cool because it's like when you got a brother, you kind of almost, I mean, like I'm close with both my brothers, but I'm really, really close with my really younger brother, and I think it's because, you know, you kind of take care of them and stuff when they're, look out for them when they're that much littler than you. Whereas, like, when you're, you know, closer in age, you kind of almost, like, kind of compete, you know. But, like, he used to be, like, you couldn't do anything when he was around. He was like a real kind of a tension monger, I guess, you know. He's not that bad, but I mean, he was just, you know, it was like, I couldn't imagine, like, you know, when he was little, we used to call him Timmy, but I couldn't imagine just being like, okay, Timmy, I gotta, you know, go draw for a while, go outside and entertain yourself. No way. He would have never went for that. But Tristan is, you know, I mean, he's got his mom there with him, but it is cool too to see, like, I don't know. I mean, when Tristan was born, he Tanya worked at Hallmark, and I was laid off for the winter because he was born right in the winter. He was born December, like, 15th. And so, that year, for some reason, was just, like, this really wet year. It rained a lot. And like I said, I used to paint houses, you know, 2 weeks ago. And I didn't go back to work for, like, the longest time. It was, like, really almost, like, June by the time I finally got back to work. And so I was home, and then, you know, Tanya, after her maternity leave, went back to work. And I stayed home and just watched Trister all the time. And I loved it, because I love kids, and, you know, of course my own kid, you know. And it was fun, and, you know, we kind of had our routine and all that kind of stuff. And Tanya, you know, she didn't have, like, a... Oh, she's got to come back right now, of course, when I'm talking about her. I can hear him outside. And she never had, like, a little brother or anything, or just had been around kids, you know. She was like the lady, you know, when you go to a party and they're handing around the baby, and then you hand it to her, and she kind of, like, holds him out, you know, away from her. And I always kind of wondered. But, like, once she became a mom and stuff. But my point, I'm going to make it super quick because I can hear him outside, is... It's really cool to see how they're, like, best friends, you know. He really, he really loves his mom, and she obviously just really loves him, and it's neat. It's just neat, because I think even, like, when she was working, she wasn't around him as much as I was, and... But once she started staying home, you know, they just bonded, you know, and it's just neat. I really love it. I guess I'm going to shut my door and just try to keep recording. Otherwise, this is going to be a super short video. Wow, there's some big crashes. I wonder what they brought home. Justin probably brought a log from the park or something. Okay, actually, I had to turn the camera off for a while. I guess I'm just going to wrap this one up and make it a short video. It didn't really work recording some more stuff once I got home. Sorry it's kind of short, but I'll do better tomorrow. Thanks for all the support. Thanks for all the shares. And I'll see you guys.